34% of adults report feeling so stressed out most days that it's overwhelming. That's a pretty tough statistic, but with the right tools, managing your to-do list doesn't have to add to that stress. There are plenty of productivity techniques and apps designed to help manage endless tasks. One of those apps is Todoist. Today we'll cover, what is Todoist? How do you use its best features? What are its pros and cons? And is it the right productivity app to help you avoid feeling overwhelmed? By the end of this, you'll know whether Todoist is the right tool to help keep your stress in check. I'm Kyle, and I've been trying out a bunch of different productivity apps to find what works for me, and hopefully this'll help you too. So what is Todoist? Todoist is a productivity app that focuses on one thing, making and managing to-do lists quickly and efficiently. It focuses on simplicity, both in design and functionality. Your task lists are accessible across devices, with different views, and can even be shared with teammates if you're using the Business Edition. The free version lets you track up to 5 personal projects with 3 filter views and a week's worth of activity history. If you need more, the Pro editing bumps it up to 300 projects, adds a calendar layout, 150 filter views, and unlimited activity history. For teams, the Business Edition takes things further. A shared team workspace, 500 team projects, and up to 1,000 team members, guests, and project folders. As of the recording of this video, the Pro license will run you $4 per month, and the Business license will run you $6 per user per month when billed yearly. In short, Todoist is a productivity app that helps you make, organize, and complete your to-do lists, and that's great. But how do you use all these features? Let's take a look under the hood and I'll show you how to do all the stuff that I just mentioned. On the left-hand side of your screen, you can see all the different tabs that my work is organized under. Starting with the inbox, this is where all my items that aren't assigned to any specific projects go by default. Here, where it says Add Task, if I click there, I can type in some simple tasks that I need to knock out for my day. This quick add feature is pretty intelligent and has a few shortcuts baked in that make entering to-do items super quick. I can just type something in directly like this, or I can grab a list from somewhere else and paste it in. Notice when I try to paste in anything with line breaks in it, it asks if I want to enter those in as one single item or if I want to enter them as individual tasks. Also, you'll notice if I include times or days in the name of your tasks, Todoist will automatically update the due date for you. For instance, if I type in something like finish edit by 5 p.m. today, it will highlight the bits that it's using to determine that due date, and below the task name, you can see the due date is now set to today, 5 p.m. It's pretty clever and can pick up on lots of things like noon, every Friday, every other Wednesday, or the first Monday of every month. That said, sometimes you don't necessarily want that to be the case. To avoid that automation from happening, all I have to do is click on those highlighted bits and it will just return it back to a regular text title. Speaking of the due date, you'll see below the task name there are extra items that can help you further classify and customize your tasks. In the due date, you can set the date and time. There's a priority flag that will allow you to sort your list by the defined priority, and reminders that can generate alerts for each item. Below that, you can see inbox with a drop-down arrow. If you click on that, you can assign this task to one of your projects for organizational purposes. Once I've created an item, I can click on it to fine-tune it a bit more. The most important feature here is the ability to add subtasks, which work functionally the same as individual tasks, but they just roll up under a larger task. Also, this is where I can leave comments, which is useful for status updates or if I need to communicate on this item with other people. I can also add labels to the item if I need any further classifications added to it. Once you've added all the details you need to your item, you can now see them under the different views on the left-hand side of your screen. Stuff that's due today will appear in the Today view. Upcoming will show you all of your items arranged chronologically by due date. Filters and Labels allows you to hone in on specific labels. And your Project views will isolate your view to only show you items related to each specific project. That gives you a quick rundown of the basic features of Todoist to get you started. Lastly, what are the pros and cons of using this software, and do I recommend it? Personally, I've been using Todoist for my own productivity for the last few weeks, and I like it a lot. I think a lot of apps these days try and be too many things at once, and while they might excel at one or two things, they come with all these extra bits and bobbles that I don't use, and I end up with a bunch of redundant apps that kinda do what I want, but not fully. Todoist is limited. It does one thing, and it does it well. To some, that might be a con, but to me, that's a pro. I use Todoist to organize my tasks for the day every morning, and so far I really enjoy it. But hey, I'm just one person. Here are some thoughts from some of my coworkers that have tried it. Oh, and as a note, none of us are sponsored by Todoist to talk about this, we just like talking about tech stuff.
I have ADHD, like actually lifelong, medically diagnosed by multiple psychiatrists, ADHD, and I'm always trying to find planning programs are ones that I can just list tasks in, and they don't need to require much. I just need to write down what it is that I'm doing. The problem is, if something has a lot of bells and whistles and the screen's really cluttered, I tend to get distracted, from just focusing on the task that I'm supposed to be doing. So with Todoist, I just type in a quick, brief blurb of what it is I'm supposed to be doing, what I have planned, other tasks they come up during the day from other people. I throw those on the list too. It's pretty quick and pretty easy. And I can shift them around and I can click on one and it goes pop and it disappears, because that sound helps me. It's like a satisfying thing. But yes, I enjoy Todoist because it's just simple.
I think that Todoist is a lot simpler than the competitors in the project management space, and it doesn't offer things like advanced views or pre-built templates. And so businesses who are looking for a project management tool, I would probably go for a competitor, but I do like Todoist on the personal side for simple task management.
I think this is just more of a me personally. Like, personally, I have projects more often than not that are ongoing, that are take more than one day. But that's what I don't like about it, is that it's not for me. I'm a big fan of, like, yes, there is a Kanban board in Todoist, but there's no automations. I can't really plan it out the way I usually do, like currently working on the next step, step one, step two, and then completed. Like, I like to have like a series of steps for my longer projects, just to really like organize everything. I just want more files for my folders, basically.
If you agree with Mackenzie and prefer something with many more functions and with Kanban visuals, you might want to check out ClickUp. ClickUp is a project management tool that aims to replace them all. It includes tasks, docs, goals, and chat, and even has that nice Kanban board that Mackenzie prefers. Click the link in the description below for more info on ClickUp. So, do I recommend Todoist? Yes, absolutely. But if you're like my buddy Zoe or Mackenzie and want something beyond list functionality, it might not be for you. I love getting the chance to do a video with some of my buddies, so if you like that, check out this video where we interviewed our HR team to talk about fixing up your resume for job interviews. And don't forget to visit technologyadvice.com for more tech advice and other goodies. Thanks as always for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.